Hello, and welcome to this pre-recorded event for GCSE Food Technology. To help you get the most out of this feedback, you may want to have the following documents handy, as we will refer to them during the session. Unit specification, question paper, mark scheme, Principal Examiner's Report 2015. Our aims and objectives are as follows. Delegates will receive feedback on national performance of candidates in the June 2015 series. Consider the variation in performance of candidates on different questions and possible reasons why. Students will develop knowledge and understanding of a wide range of materials, nutrition, equipment, processes, current health issues, and technological development used in design and technology. The assessment objectives consist of the following tested skills: AO1, recall, select, and communicate their knowledge and understanding in D&T, including its wider effects. AO2, apply knowledge, understanding, and skills in a variety of contexts and in designing and making products. AO3, analyze and evaluate products, including their design and production. The delivery of knowledge, understanding, and skills in the theory paper continues to show good progression for a wide range of ingredients, components, materials, and processes. This is through the use of primary and secondary foods with the focus on food preparation, processing and preservation, nutrition and health issues, product analysis, and product manufacture topics across food technology at both a domestic and industrial level of application. There were a range of levels of outcome for candidates. This paper contained a broad and varied distribution of marks across the paper, which achieved a good balance of recall, selection, application, and communication of knowledge and understanding in food technology, as well as product analysis and evaluation, through short and extended writing activities, as well as the design question. The table shows the maximum raw mark and the raw grade boundary marks for each of the units. The raw mark is the mark that a candidate achieves when an assessment is marked. For unitized qualifications, this raw mark is then converted to a uniform mark, otherwise known as UMS. The grade descriptors are presented on this slide and can also be found in the specification guidance. Centres need to be aware of the necessity to prepare candidates for this exam by ensuring that they have a full understanding of the requirements of different question types. Give, state, name. Describe, outline. Explain, justify. Evaluate, discuss, compare. Often candidates had difficulty in achieving the full marks for questions asking for an explanation, because answers were not supported with relevant linked examples or reasoning. Additionally, some of the technical questions relating to food products and nutritional understanding were incorrect or vague. Centres must focus on technical understanding, to enable candidates to access the higher marks. The design question was extremely well received, and significant improvements have been seen with the quality of sketched and written communication by candidates. Additionally, the extended writing answers were much better organized, with good planning and use of terminology presented by candidates. In the short answer questions, candidates tended to fare better when their answer contained a full sentence with examples where appropriate. The preparation and processing techniques of ingredients are integral to food technology. Mixed responses were seen regarding the classification of fish. The majority of candidates knew about the white and oily fish, but were definitely confused when identifying the shellfish and crustaceans. This particular response was awarded full marks. The vast majority of candidates were only awarded one mark in this question. They had a good knowledge of local business and fair trade, but when asked to quantify it, they couldn't or didn't know how. The most common responses were to do with local business, fair trade, and recycling of packaging. However, there was significant confusion that buying from the local supermarket meant that this supported local business or fair trade, despite the fact the fruit had been flown into the UK from the other side of the world. This slide identifies what worked well for candidates. The design question produced some excellent responses from candidates, with high-quality sketching and annotation from candidates across the ability range. The link between coursework activities in the design task was most apparent, with some innovative food product design work. A wide range of savoury salad products were presented, with most candidates managing to illustrate and label two different ideas. Centres continue to work hard to raise achievement in this section of the question paper. All examiners noted the continued improvement in communication techniques and the ability of the candidates to be creative, imaginative, and at times quite inventive with their recipes. Where candidates had read the question carefully and planned their answer methodically, and sketches and annotation succeeded in showing how the design had met the specification points, they were rewarded with some high marks. It is not acceptable to just label the specification points. They must be annotated, indicating how the design has met each point. This was a popular question, and the majority of candidates responded fully. Some of the designs were very good, being fully annotated and sketched well. There seemed to be a logical process in answering, where the candidate had worked through the specification points one by one. The point that caused greatest difficulty was regarding value for money. Responses needed to focus on ways this can be achieved. Therefore, correct answers could have referenced that the food product contained ingredients that were home-grown, seasonal, or batch-produced to reduce manufacturing costs. Once again, candidates who planned their answers carefully were rewarded with high marks because they used the specification as a checklist to ensure they covered all the points. I will briefly list the main points for consideration for each specification point. 1. Pastry technique. The most common answer was puff and short crust, but a lot included rubbing in and folding as the technique. 2. Finishing technique. This was well answered, with the most common response being glazes, egg or milk, and or scoring on the outer crust for decoration. 3. High in protein. Well answered by most candidates, with meat, cheese, fish and eggs the most common responses. 4. Suitable for batch production. Varied responses, with a lot of candidates gaining 0 marks. When answered correctly, standard components was the most common. 5. High in fiber. Well answered, with wholemeal flour or baked beans being the most popular answers. A few candidates put down meat and fish as including fiber. 6. Easy to transport for a picnic. Good responses for this, with most candidates including dimensions or referring to the size of the product with weight, style and shapes. 7. Value for money. This was not answered well by candidates, and this was the question not answered by a lot of candidates. The most common answer was local, buy one get one free, BOGOF. Disappointing responses. The percentage content of protein to carbohydrate and industry discounts such as BOGOF, loyalty schemes at bakery, seasonality of fruit and veg, weight or portion size compared to cost, bulk buying ingredients, were a few outstanding responses. 8. Use ICT in food production process. Mixed responses by candidates with limited knowledge and understanding about ICT uses in food production. Some knowledge of CAD when designing, costing, and nutritional analysis of the product. Little explanations included, and limited annotation by candidates. Problems occurred for candidates where they either repeated answers or rewrote the specification point, rather than showing how their chosen design met the specification point. Vague inaccuracies, or omitting answers completely, meant that some candidates were unable to access the full 16 marks. What worked well for candidates is summarized on the slide. Students tended to perform well in the design question, where they had planned their answers carefully. Label each design with the name of the product. Annotate each specification point. Numbering also works well as a checklist on the exam paper. Be specific with dimensions, weight, tolerances, ingredients and processes. Be creative and adventurous with your design ideas. Make it busy. Most candidates showed an understanding of design, but this could be improved by reading the question carefully. Delegates can pause the video to carry out the activity if they wish, at the example. Using the mark scheme, decide what mark you think should be awarded and why. Answers are linked to specification points. 5 + 5 marks awarded for these answers. Design idea 1. 1 puff pastry, 1 egg, 1 sausage, 0 production, 1 flour, 1 dimensions, 0 value, 0 CIM, computer-aided manufacture, is too vague. Equals 5 marks. Design idea 2. 0 pastry, 0 fruit glaze, 1 butter, one batch, one apples, one foil, zero value, one lids. Equals 5 marks. On this question, successful candidates used specific examples linked to the given context, used accurate technical vocabulary, were creative in their use of examples, understood the audience and purpose of the product. Candidates had varying degrees of success, depending on their interpretation of the command word explain. Where candidates provided a linked explanation to their initial statement, they were rewarded with the full 2 marks. The most common answers were to do with reducing waste, consistency, and to save time. This slide shows how candidates can access the marks by linking their responses carefully together with reasoning and explanation. This question was answered well by most candidates, with many gaining the full 2 marks. Many gained 1 mark for stating the packaging would be recyclable. The most popular correct response was using local fruit to reduce food miles. As an extended writing exercise linked to QWC, this question proved to be very challenging for many candidates. This question is marked using the level descriptors outlined in previous sample assessment materials, in the teacher guidance that accompanies the specification materials. Candidates must demonstrate accurate technical vocabulary linked to food technology and a good understanding of the evaluation process. Where writing communicated answers effectively, with clarity and organization, candidates were rewarded with high marks. It is possible to provide 3 to 4 well-explained evaluated points to achieve the high marks. Candidates could answer this question in either a bullet-pointed list or paragraph format, focusing on comparisons between the 2 recipes. To move the response from a weak or average answer to one that is worthy of full marks requires explanation of each comparison together with clear, effective communication throughout the response. Evaluation and comparison in this answer is worthy of a high-level response in the level descriptors. Recipe B. For manufacturers, these additives are good to use because they are easy to control due to their purity, create consistency in the product, greater use of chemicals in foods, restore flavors or colors lost during processing, improve the nutritional value of foods, prolong storage life, are placed on the permitted additives list when accepted as safe, and are reviewed by the European Food Safety Authority. Must be passed as safe by the EU and identified by an E number. Some may appear with their chemical name. Recipe A. For manufacturers, these ingredients are used because there is an increasing demand for foods without additives, particularly those considered to cause allergic and intolerant reactions. Manufacturers are working towards clean labels as a result of the concerns about the use of artificial chemicals in food. They reduce the use of artificial additives by instead using natural substances to restore, enhance, or improve the functional characteristics of food. Natural additives are often hard to control due to their instability once extracted from their plant or animal origin. Costs are likely to be reduced as there are less artificial ingredients, more natural ingredients, a shorter ingredient list. Why candidates didn't do well. Summary. Students tended to repeat the information on the ingredients without drawing any evaluation about the use or benefits of the ingredients from the manufacturer. This question posed most difficulties for candidates, as many did not appear to understand what was required of them. Those candidates gaining 0 marks tended to just repeat the ingredients list. Many also just seemed to rewrite the list of ingredients as a comparison, without giving explanations for the difference. Some candidates divided their answer sheet to make comments about each ingredient and used bullet points, which successfully gained them around 4 marks or so. Two marks awarded for danger zone temperature and linked response to food poisoning later in the answer. The question this year was split into 3 areas for 6 marks. Weaker candidates generally focused on colour change, with little discussion about the effects. Texture, flavour, aroma and colour changes, with specific links to coagulation, dextrinisation, temperature ranges for food safety, caramelisation and loss of vitamins, B and C, in vegetables provided our A-star candidates real opportunity to demonstrate their excellent food science knowledge. In these cases, the answers were a pleasure to read, and this is clearly an area of the specification that offered real scope for stretch and challenge of our most able candidates. This question was also left blank by several weaker candidates. Others that gained 0 marks did so by just writing out the question, without making any valid points. As with question 13E, the full range of marks was given for this question. Weaker candidates getting 3 marks or so for making different valid points with little discussion. Handwriting was again a major problem. Regrettably, no marks can be awarded here, as this candidate has misread the question and focused on a previous exam question, which was linked to safety and quality. Technical understanding. Good use of vocabulary and terminology linked to food technology. Excellent application of knowledge and understanding were demonstrated in written form. Credible discussion regarding the effects of cooking on the named foods. This slide summarizes, using previous examples, why candidates didn't do well. Please read the question carefully and have a go at marking the candidate's response. You may want to pause the video at this point to carry out the activity. Look at the example above. Using the mark scheme, decide what mark you think should be awarded and why. Meat. Colouring from pink to brown, 1. Change of texture and to make it tender, 1. Eggs. Salmonella, food poisoning. Change of structure from soft to hard, 1. And coagulation, 1, with temperatures included. Vegetables. Makes vegetables soft, 1. And they lose their nutritional makeup. Vitamin B and C, water-soluble vitamins, 1. Mark scheme guidance. Meat. Protein coagulates between 40 degrees C and 60 degrees C. Meat muscle shrinks and fat melts. Color changes depending on method of cooking. Red to brown, pink to white. Tougher cuts of meat require slow, moist methods of cooking to tenderize meat. Vitamin B loss in moist methods of cooking. Develops flavor. Cooked above 72 degrees C kills most bacteria. Prevents food poisoning. Eggs. Egg white coagulates at 60 degrees C, changing from transparent to opaque. Yolk becomes firm, change of texture. Egg yolk coagulates at 70 degrees C. Rapid cooking will cause synerosis, where the egg separates and proteins become tough. Weeping of liquid from egg. Color change, for example, glazes. Cooking methods will alter properties. Food safety, awareness linked to killing bacteria with high temperatures. Vegetables. Soften. Flavor change linked to method of cooking, roasting, caramelizing. Color change. Water-soluble vitamins B and C are easily destroyed by heat. Therefore, it is important to add vegetables to boiling water to destroy enzymes and retain vitamins. Steam vegetables. Reduce cooking time. Use microwave in order to reduce cooking time, liquid, and therefore loss of vitamin C. Reuse cooking water for soups, sauces, gravies, or stock for flavor and color. Serve vegetables immediately once cooked. This slide shows a summary of common issues with the past paper, along with some suggestions for ways to improve.